G'day. Do you remember a couple of videos back, I told you that we were hopeful that because of my cancer diagnosis?
That diagnosis does mean that hopefully I can make a claim on my life insurance. Maybe we can get a bit of a payout, perhaps get a deposit together for a house, because this is just a rental. It would be nice to set the family up in our own place while I'm still around.
Well, we've been able to do it. It's happening. We've bought a house and settlement is in about an hour. We get the keys. We've got lots of boxes. So in this video, I'll be documenting the move and we'll give you a bit of a guided tour of the new house as well. And just whatever else happens along the way this week during the whole process. So I've got the first load that's going out to the new house on the back of the ute. It's our eldest son Josh's bed and a table and bits and pieces. So Josh is going to be staying at the new house for the first few days while we spend most of this week just moving little stuff. And then I've got a truck coming this weekend to move the bigger stuff, and we'll be in there from then. So we're packing stuff up. We've got some boxes in Mandy's car. Josh's little car is loaded up as well with bits and pieces and his beloved computer equipment. Can't leave that behind. Good on you, Josh. That's what was underneath Josh's bed. So the weather today was supposed to be fine, but when we got up this morning, it was raining, Murphy's Law. So that's why the bedding there is all covered up in the tarp and what have you. But the rain stopped now, still a bit of cloud around. But hopefully it stays dry for us and we can get a lot of moving done today. And Mandy's got her car loaded up as well. There she is. We ready to go?
Ready.
Okay, let's go.
Let's go, Josh.
So we're on our way to the real estate and he's just called to say settlement hasn't quite gone through yet. Might be another 10 minutes or so. So we're just going to grab a coffee. So we're at Macca's. Grab ourselves a latte, McCafe, whatever, and then head to the real estate to get the keys.
Oh.
And
stuff that up.
Mandy's goofed up her parking. Well done, Mandy. All right, coffee it is. You excited?
Yep. All day.
Cool. So there's been a little bit of a hold up with the settlement being processed. So we're just at the agent, waiting. Hopefully it won't be long and we'll get the keys to our new house. All right, we've got the keys. Now back to the house and start moving in.
Yippee!
So there it is, key to our new house. What do you reckon, Mandy?
Awesome.
Good day?
Yep.
Just got to learn our way around town now. Okay, so we've got the keys, we're at the new house. Before we start moving in and it starts to look ordinary with boxes and stuff, let's do a quick guided tour. So nice big front door. That'll be the living room. We have master bedroom and all that's down there. Fireplace. We have big kitchen. We have sister-in-laws that are hiding behind doors. the previous owners had a TV on the wall, so we're just going to have to patch up that hole, unless we put a TV there ourselves. Dining area, I think that will be. Bedrooms on this side, bathrooms on that side. And we come through to big ass garage. And cameo appearance by Josh. And now let's start moving in. So the previous owner did apologise that when he was trying to clean out the garage, the rain was coming in and he just couldn't clean it. So he apologised, that's fine. So I put Josh to work with the broom now. Sweep up the bit of mud that's in the garage before we start unloading stuff. Good on you, Josh. Okay, I've been up to Mum and Dad's and picked up the trailer that we loaded a few weeks back with some bits and pieces. Cameo appearance from Carla. Hi, Carla.
Sup?
Happy to be in your new house?
Yeah.
Yeah? Okay, so it's coming up towards 10 o'clock at night. We've done another run. We've unloaded a trailer, unloaded the ute again, because we brought over the fridge and freezer from the garage at our old place. So the beer fridge and the freezer. So we've got those over here. Also checking out the internet connection here. It's actually fibre to the premises. So that yellow wire is the fibre that comes in. I've just got this old laptop plugged in directly. And if I do a run the speed test here, and we can see now, I was expecting a bit more than that, and I've seen up to 100, but I think that's a limitation of this laptop. So once we get some more gear set up and our new Orbi Wi-Fi mesh system, should be able to get some really good speeds. This old laptop, I think it's limited to 100. That's your upload speed. That's pretty good. Let's just run that again. What do we get? Yep, so it's maxing out just over 100. So I'm pretty sure that's a limitation of this laptop. But even that is about three times better than we were getting at our old place. And once we've got everything set up properly, we should see better speed still. Anyway, I'll just quickly show you what else we've done. Would you believe we've brought the dining chairs over, but not the dining table. That happens later. So that's that. Kitchen still a bit bare, but I go down to Josh's room. So Josh will be staying here all by himself tonight.
Oh boy.
He's got his bed there set to go. He's got his temporary desk.
Oh boy.
And he would really like me to set up the internet for him tonight, but I would really like to go home. What is that desktop picture, Josh? What is that? Is that your brother?
No.
Is that you?
No.
What is that?
It's Markiplier judging you.
What?
It's... Don't what me.
Who is it?
Don't...
I've no idea. Should we set up your internet? No. You want to go to bed early?
No.
Sure.
Okay. No.
So, I'm laying on the floor because there's pretty much no furniture. But we've got the internet set up. Got these fancy Orbi mesh Wi-Fi things. And we're connected to, got it all set up to the internet, to the fiber, to the home internet. And I'll tell you what, the download speed is pretty impressive. Let's go see Josh and his computer and see what he thinks. Josh is running another speed test. Did we hit 500? Yes, 500. Do we hear 600?
No. Maybe it's capped somehow.
Maybe. Pretty damn impressive though. I got up to 800 on my phone.
Well, aren't you special?
That's Wi-Fi, and it's Wi-Fi 6, which is supposed to be super fast.
Well, there you go.
So we're supposed to be getting up to 1,000.
Supposed to be.
So there you go. So down here is another Orbi satellite.
Would it go into the satellite, make it slower, or?
What do you mean?
Would it, going through that, make it slower?
Maybe. I don't know.
Still pretty fast.
It's still about 100 times faster than you had it at the old house. Anyway, so you're all connected?
Yep.
So there you go. I reckon I'm going to head home, or to the old home.
Yep.
And leave you here all by yourself with your super fast internet.
Well, it's the next day, Wednesday,
and we're loading up for another trip of stuff out to the new house. Mandy's even got Tigger loaded into the front seat of the car. I've got the bikes and some exercise stuff loaded in the back of the ute, and some boxes and bits and pieces loaded up into the trailer. All right, Mandy.
Let's go.
Let's hit the road. Oh, I better put the cover back on the trailer. But yeah, let's hit the road. Have to be a little bit careful with our time management because we're attending a funeral this afternoon, but should be all right to get rid of all this and then make it back. Okay, we're in the backyard of the new house. Mandy's over there having a cuppa, Josh is just helping out, and the neighbours have come to see us. How you going, Daisy? Yep, the cows have come wandering past. So our neighbours to the back are cows. It's a farm, rural property. How good's that? Okay, no dining table. The dining chairs are here, as we showed you last night, and Tigger and Pooh Bear are sitting here waiting. Very well-behaved little cartoon characters. All right, I've lost count how many loads we've done now, but the old house here is looking a lot emptier, and the new house has got lots of boxes to be unpacked in it, but we're making headway. And the sun's in my eyes. Now there's a shadow on my face. Right, the move continues. We've got a load of shelves and tables and a Pooh Bear thing going out to the new house. And a trailer load of bits and pieces. So I've just arrived at the house, backed the trailer and ute in with another load, opened the back roller door into the backyard, and was greeted by some cows. Country living, how's that? Got my grandfather's workbench. This thing's probably 60 years old. I can remember banging nails into this thing as a 5 or 6 year old. And it's followed me everywhere I've gone since I pretty much moved out of home. And now it's going to the new house. Had to enlist Josh to help load it up. I reckon at the other end, I'll get Brad and Josh to unload it. I'll just sit back and watch. We just pulled up at the new house and we're getting ready to unload everything. And we just noticed the neighbours, I don't know if you can see, there's a couple of big ass parrots in there that started talking to us. So I couldn't put Brad to work. He's still at school doing a exam school thing. So Josh and I got my grandpa's old desk into the shed here that's at the new house. So here we go. The move continues. So our eldest son Josh's room is almost empty. So we're getting there, we're making progress. Our daughter's room, Carla, still a little bit of work to do. Mandy's filling boxes on her behalf. Now, the task at hand at the moment is my other son, Brad. In his room, we have a monolith, is that the word? Of a desk that I need to try and unassemble. So that's today's project, and then throw that on the ute or in the trailer or somewhere and get it out to the new house. Okay, managed to get that monolith of a corner desk unit pulled apart. Most of it got into the ute. We've had to put a little bit, little corner section there into the, oh, don't fall! Little section there into the trailer as well. In hindsight, I probably should have left that for the truck that's coming tomorrow. But nonetheless, we've got it in. Now just fill up the trailer with some other bits and pieces, whatever we can squeeze in there, and then head off out to the new house again. Okay, so we've got a bit happening today. We've pulled about the beds, and we did have a removalist truck booked for today. Although they just rung up and asked if they can cancel because one of their boys has hurt himself. We've said, no, that's a bit of a pain in the ass. So they're gonna try and find someone else, but it looks like our removalist truck isn't coming. We've got couches pulled apart. Like I said, all the beds are pulled apart. So now we're in a bit of a mad rush to try and do as much as we can with our own ute and trailer. It's actually the work ute. But fingers crossed the removalist people can find someone else to come and help, and they can still do a load. Otherwise, it's going to be a bit of a panic today to try and get some beds over to the new house to try and have somewhere to sleep. So there's Brad's bed, his mattress. That's the base and everything in pieces. Even Carla's bed. It's an IKEA bed. There was a pain in the ass to put together, and now we can't remember how to pull it apart. So hopefully we can do something with that. Anyway, we're off to do a mad rush, little run in the ute, grab the trailer again, come back. Fingers crossed the removalist people can find someone to come. If not, we'll be busy people today. All right, update soon. Well, last night I had my first night in the new house. Mandy had to go back to the old house though. I said that the movers couldn't come yesterday as planned, so they were there first thing this morning. So Mandy's gone back and stayed there last night ready for them. So that was a bit of a pain that they couldn't come, so it was a bit of a mad rush. We did manage to get the beds. Did manage to get the beds over there. Get those together. So me and the kids are just heading back, or Brad and Carla are just heading back to the old house now. Hopefully the movers can get everything and we'll just pick up the dribs and drabs, and that should be it. So there you go, more updates soon. So there you go, the old house is empty, and there's a bit of an echo in here now with no furniture or anything. So it's been a week, and this hasn't been anything really cinematic or anything. This whole video has just been recorded on my phone, just a bit of a vlog of the whole process of getting into the new house. I'll do a follow-up video as soon as we can, once we're all out of the boxes and set up properly in the new home. We'll do a follow-up video on that, so stay tuned. And thanks for watching, and I will see you in that next video really soon. Cheers. Thanks for watching.